In our Purchase or Pass segment this week, we take a look at a property as advertised as having parking, but all is not as it seems. It's a two-bed, one-bath unit with parking, 8.3 kilometres from the CBD and less than 500 metres to the local action. At 110 square metres, it's one of the largest units in the area and boasts a north-facing garden. It's situated in a small federation block of four and has 3.2 metre high pattern ceilings and lime-washed floorboards. It's advertised as having a parking area, but you can only get two cars in there. It recently sold for $1.35 million and rents for approximately about $900 a week. Now, good to see you on the show, Evan. Thanks for filling in for Charles Darby. He's on his awards night.
He is, yes.
So, obviously, look, I mean, you're fairly kind of close in the area as well, but 110 square metres, for a lot of people around Australia, that's pretty small, but in those areas, it's pretty large. How important is size on a property?
Look, size for a property, especially a rental property, is very important. 110 square metres represents pretty good size. The issue, as you pointed out, though, is the parking for this one. That's something I think we should discuss. Is parking important? Do we need parking? I think yes, especially for an investment property. But yeah, these are the things to consider for this property. And I think that the yield, as we saw there, wasn't as high as it could have been. And I think the introduction of, if it had a designated car spot, that could really improve the rental return and increase the yield, make it a bit much more worthwhile investment.
Yeah, so certainly things to think about. Now, obviously, one of the main things here is it's got a garden.
Yep.
You see, obviously, the adverts, and on your site, you can tick if you want those kind of things. How rare is it to have something like that, again, in the inner city?
Yeah, look, I think being in the inner city and having that green space is a real positive for this property. And you know, it does have that drawback of the scattered parking or shared parking, but it's got size, and not just the whole block size of 110 square metres, but also the individual bedrooms are a really big size. And so we see a lot more people actually wanting to see big bedrooms rather than more bedrooms. So I think this place does a good job of presenting that. And then the outdoor area is a real bonus as well. So in an apartment, you're almost getting an extra room for those in Sydney 7 or 8 months of the year when you can be living outside. So any sort of outdoor area we see as a big driver of engagement. So anytime there's a balcony, a small garden or a courtyard, we see a lot more interest for people looking at our properties.
Yeah, and I guess it all comes down to the competition. I mean, we were talking earlier on about things like Go Get or even having
a car stacker.
That's an opportunity these days.
I mean, the body corporate here could definitely, maybe not for this property, but it could consider putting in a stacker. This way, every property would be able to have a car park on title, and that will definitely increase the rental yield, making this property a lot more attractive to investors.
And again, looking at some of the other properties, say around the CBDs and in these bigger developments, quite often they have kind of the bike racks and the motorcycles and even shared bikes you see in a lot of the, I know it's up in Brisbane and places like that, that it is a different way of thinking. So I've always been very set on the parking, but it's a changing world, isn't it?
I think if you get into the inner city areas and the roads really tight inner city suburbs, a place like West End in Brisbane, and in the Perth CBD area, I think parking's becoming less of an issue potentially for those who work in the CBD, live in the CBD, and they do have access to Uber, Go Get, all those other ride-sharing services, as well as the good old taxi every now and then.
Yeah, and I guess with the scattered parking as well is different. If you normally come home at about 3 in the afternoon, say you pick up the kids, that's probably actually an advantage, whereas if you're a late night, say if you're an accountant or a real estate agent working till 9 or 10 at night, then you're probably
going to
be the last one.
The thing that tends to happen to these, there's usually a status quo forms until a new tenant moves in, then it gets sort of up in the air again until everything settles down. So,
yeah. So, purchase or pass for you?
Pass for me.
And what about yourself?
I'll be contrarian. I'll purchase.
You're going to go for a purchase? Sounds good. Now, for me, while scattered parking is better than no parking, I'd rather wait and find something with a guaranteed space. And the low yield gives a hint to me that someone may be paid over the odds as they really wanted that garden apartment because they are pretty unique. So, at the moment, I'd pass as well. Anyway, now it's time to take a look around the